Moo on his Timbersaw?
Moo's Timbersaw, and pretty much all of Digital Chaos. They are hitting a serious stride. They're up at the top of their group, and if they walk away with the series with 2 points, they will be there at the top of the group, and they will, what looks like, likely secure a spot into the upper bracket. And that's a huge accomplishment. That's going to be the biggest win for DC in their history.
Yeah, definitely. If they score one more win here, this game that we're playing right now, they are definitely guaranteed to go in the winner bracket. They will be at 8 points after 5 games. And even so, they will also have a game remaining against Liquid and Eholm. So those are... Liquid has not been having a good time as well. They've only been drawing or losing so far. Eholm, of course, they are up there, though. Yeah. They have only dropped a single game.
And that's the one thing Liquid have going for them.
Exactly.
Is the one win on Eholm.
They did what no one else has done. They took a game off Eholm, the wild card team.
But nonetheless, it's like, if DC could just etch out this win here, then they might be a little less pressure having to face a game against Liquid, because Liquid are going to come back fighting tomorrow. Like,
oh, yeah.
Already being in this position, they're going to try to just make work out of DC.
Definitely.
And DC would have to be more ready.
If DC lost here in this game, then they definitely could be in a position that Eholm and Liquid come out really strong, and they don't get in the upper bracket. So they're so close right now to securing it. They just need to play just like they did in a previous game.
And for Secret, whatever's happening psychologically here, if you feel like you're on tilt or whatever, you got to shake it off right here and now, pump the Taylor Swift or whatever you got to do, and then come bring your A game. You got to walk away with the win. You got to do it for yourselves. You got to do it for Secret fans.
I'm going to start whispering Huskar in there of the Secret players.
Oh, God. Second phase. I hope to not see a bit of that again.
Unpredicted Secret Huskar pickup. That was very strange. From a drafting perspective, I really feel that they were beating themselves. It could maybe have worked if they played really, really stellar, but it was not an easy game to outplay. And
no more Kunkka.
A third pick Huskar is not that powerful at all. I feel that you can just counter it with the Timbersaw pick, the CK, and even the core Mirana is fairly decent against it. You later on build it into an E-Blade, which is good.
Yeah. We saw the late debut of CK, and he's now undefeated. Mm-hmm. Good for him.
Yeah, that's very nice. The Chaos team with the Chaos hero.
Secret get a Mirana Faceless Void 1-2 punch to start out their draft. DC take their first pick advantage and snag up one of the best first picks you could ask for, the Elder Titan.
I like how both the Mirana and the Void are block picks against the Elder Titan combo, because if you have Void and Elder Titan, of course, you get the crack guaranteed. Uh-huh. And if you have Elder Titan Mirana, then the stomp will set up for Arrow very well. And ironically, when you pick up these two heroes that go with Elder Titan, they also go well with themselves. So, really good for Team Secret here blocking. Beastmaster going to be picked up.
And DC's move will be snagging up the Beastmaster here. Kind of shows that their overall lineup have an ability to ramp up the tempo really fast. Beastmaster does, of course, have that pushing factor, the extra lockdown that will pierce through BKBs, and just the ability that when they take a significant team fight, they can easily follow it up with good objectives. Oh, and add on top of that, he provides great map vision too, so.
Yeah, and that's really what they need, just seeing where Secret are headed at all times. They did have really good wards down in the previous game. They managed to make decisions based off that and getting pickoffs around it. So I think the Digital Chaos realize how much it is about vision. We saw some previous games today where Slark, for instance, where Secret were playing it. Everything in that game was about vision, trying to find out your opponent and trying to see what they're doing. So yeah, Beastmaster naturally helps with that.
Also, got to consider those other cheese options. We see one cheese option there, Huskar going to be banned out. But Drow is still there, Wagga.
She is still available. I think if anyone will go for it, it will probably be Team Secret.
Yeah.
Sure, you have Beastmaster on Digital Chaos, so you could maybe build into it. You could definitely go for a Drow plus Medusa, for instance.
Or get Avenge too to help against the Void and benefit from the double aura. I could see DC do that.
Sure, they can definitely still build into it. So the question becomes here: does Team Secret care about it, or are they gonna? No, they're not gonna ban it at all. All right, we got the answer.
I mean, you gotta respect also the Weehawk Invoker. He's been
the Wee Voker.
It's been said from other pro players he's one of the best, if not the best, in the game.
Yeah,
playing this Invoker.
Oh, he's definitely up there with the rest. There's so many good Invoker players. There's probably five that I hold in the absolute top, and he's definitely one of them, along with a lot of Chinese players. Maybe is the first one that comes to mind to me. for Grady Wolkers.
Well, there's our answer. DC will just rid of the Drow altogether. They don't find a. They're not thinking of finding a way to build it into their own lineup, and they don't want Secret to get it into theirs. So that's a good double slash of cheese here in the second phase for DC.
Let's see what they go for here, pairing up. They have the Void, they have the Mirana.
5 seconds.
I think there's definitely some merit to even taking the Vengeful for yourself here.
Do you go back for the Kunkka again? For the fourth game straight?
No. I think Kunkka does not work for Secret.
We see it sometimes. They played it.
They played it well. They have some combinations, but they don't manage to translate the early game into a total win the way many other teams do, with just every rotation kind of turns into kills, turns into towers. Secret hasn't had that steam going. Whether it's because of the draft or because of the play, it doesn't really matter. I think they should just try something different here.
If not something different, go back to what has worked before. What about just getting Puppy something like the Chen or Enchantress?
Yeah, for sure. He plays those extremely well. The downside, of course, playing Chen, Elder Titan loves being against Chen. He really does. That stomp is amazing against all those creeps. So gonna go for the Witch Doctor first here. Nothing to say that Mirana is not gonna be a core though. So, I mean, every time that Secret run it, it's pretty much guaranteed to be a core. Envy and Arteezy both love it. There's that Venge Beastmaster combo we were talking about. The auras are stacking up.
Yep, stacking auras. A good way to eject somebody out of that chrono if necessary.
Sure.
And, you know, adds a... And extra bit of lockdown.
It's really the power of friendship kind of lineup right now. You have the minus armor from Elder Titan and from Venge, and then you have all the right play coming in with the Beast and Venge combination.
Aura strat right here, baby.
It really
is. Let's just keep this party going. What else can we stack on top of this to make it like that five man?
Sven, man. Sven. Let's go. He'll just pump everyone up. Sven, you know when he used to buy the acronyms, it says Sven gets you pumped up or something.
Really?
Yeah, there's some flavor text.
I think that only like a handful of times we've actually seen a Ags on a Sven. Yeah. Just kind of a fun little luxury.
It would have been fun with a Beast Dimension in your team, dude.
That would be crazy.
And also Elder Titan's aura. You would have some crazy damage.
Crazy.
But I, for some reason, don't think that DC are going to be playing on a Sven at all.
What about a Lycan for DC?
Well, they do like playing it.
We haven't seen a lot of Lycan recently, but this might be one of those times.
Mm-hmm. They could go back for it. They will see a Sanking picked up. More than likely, it's going to be a carry Void now, is what I feel. With the Sanking snag, it's just such a great great offlaner. He can be put on the mid position as well, but that would not be what I expect from Secret here.
The Morphling from DC. Morphling kind of... I don't know. Morphling is kind of it's good. I mean,
he works with auras really well.
He works with auras fine.
Yeah.
It does say that DC aren't going with like a five-man stampede though.
I think they're not going with a stampede. They're building very safely into the late game. They also now have a carry that can easily join them whenever they want since of the replicate. So I like this Morphling pickup. And one final thing is that he's really good at bursting down Witch Doctor quickly. And it's not easy at all to be a position 5 Witch Doctor against it. If you don't have any items, you kind of need the Glimmer Cape, or you're just dead to the Adaptive Strike all the time.
And it comes along with the typical Morphling package we always expect to see. The survivability, whether caught in Chrono, hit by Arrow, whatever, he would be able to kind of live on and be very elusive. And as you mentioned, good at getting around the map when necessary. So,
banning out the Batrider as well. They're scared of... Batrider after the
Beastmaster? Yeah. I mean, hey, Resolution used to play a lot of Beastmaster, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, I don't know.
But he won't be playing a...
I guess Batrider is just that much of a problem against Secret's lineup and their potential fifth pick?
No, they're just scared of a mid Batrider from Weehaw. But I don't think that's what they're going to go for at all. It's a strange ban to me by Team Secret, but it would be painful to play against. Void does not like the damage over time at all. Not one bit.
Yeah.
Batrider is a nasty hero in that regard.
I am curious what the Weehaw hero actually is going to be. Gotta always throw out a casual Meepo, but now the Sand King
DP
coming out.
Is still definitely there, and he plays it really well. And it would add a lot of push to their lineup. They have so much fighting already. Silence is great here as well. So I wouldn't put it past them to go DP here. There's a few other heroes that they could go for, but DP or Puck, actually, I think are two really good pickups.
DC's
maybe with the Sand King, they now have the potential that if they put a melee to the mid lane, they could audible the Sand King there, I guess.
Yeah, I don't think it's gonna be a melee mid hero at all. We'll see. It could be a Juggernaut, I guess, but
10 seconds
don't think
remaining.
It's gonna happen. We'll see. DC, give me the juice. What's happening?
5 seconds.
Tell me the story. Is it gonna be Puck? Is it gonna be a DP?
Gotta throw out Meepo just because it's Wii, huh? You know,
dude, you don't want to play that against Sand King.
I know, but just Sand King. Never know. DK.
Oh, okay. Well, it does play similarly to the DP, but
yeah.
I did not expect to see a Dragonite coming out. The long stun durations are insane, though, on the side of DC, and that makes it hard to be any of these elusive heroes that wanna in and out of the fight. Mirana, Void, Sand King, all of them trying to get away quickly after doing their dirty work.
So you see a Dragonite in your secret here. Do you put the Sand King mid lane? Do you grab something else to match
up
against him?
I think it looks like it.
It looks like it.
Great time to do it. Just offlane Void, safe lane carry Mirana. But Bulba is going to be the one to pick the Sand King. Doesn't say that it's not going to be mid though. Definitely still doable, but we'll see. I just think it's such a great matchup against the Dragonite.
Do you feel a bit more confident now with Secret Strath than what we saw for like game number one? Do you think that this is the lineup for them to be able to get that one win at least today?
I don't feel confident with Secret right now. It's not something I can say, but you know, there's a potential. I love the Sand King pickup, and I love the fact that they switch away from the Kunkka, that they ran a lot of times, even though other teams have been successful with it. I like teams that bring their own stuff, that bring what they are comfortable with, what they will play. DC did that in the previous game. Hell, we bring a Chaos Knight, we don't care. You know, like that kind of attitude, it gets you really far, makes you confident in yourself. And I think right now, Team Secret, more than anything, they need to believe in themselves. They have a lot of strong players, but it can get in your head losing this many games in a row. It really can.
Let's begin the action here as we get started. An early smoke will be there for Secret as we get underway for game number two of our final match for day two group stage coverage here at TI6.
Oh, he saw the TP in. Misery. When he TP'd out, they know that there's a smoked hero, and Saxa is going to reveal it.
Oh, they're going to look to cut him off here. There's a magic missile. Misery can wait and go for the stomp. Pumps fake once. Puppy comes back. Might wait for it to go for it again, but the right clicks continue to come out from Saxa.
Not going
to
get the body block, though. He does have a stun again, so this should
there
be a kill.
Is. With the stomp. Oh, he doesn't go for it.
No, they don't need
too
to.
Short
they
duration. They got him done. Quick first blood already for DC.
That was very heads up. The fact that Misery is so quick at TPing out. He bought all his items in a flash and just TPed out on mid lane. He was there to see the TP come in and break the trees. And, you know, these two things. Seeing the TP animation, I'm not even sure he saw that or if it was just the trees he saw being cut.
Stuff like that happens. It makes it hard whenever people feel like, oh, we got to introduce every player or go over predictions, because that's the stuff you miss.
You don't have to do that. We know these guys by now, but for anyone who doesn't know, sure.
I don't want to have to do all that. No, that's what I'm saying is that I worry because Dota has become such a fickle game that even that first initial start right as the gun goes off.
Oh, Dota starts in the first second, man.
Yeah,
there's no rest. In professional games, you don't get any single second that you can waste.
I feel like that's just something, though, that's evolved more and more over time. Like, when I first started casting, it didn't feel like doing wards, doing TPs and smoke plays like that wasn't as relevant.
It's a meta thing. Really, it's a meta thing. They nerfed or they buffed the TP scroll by making it cheaper, and that makes more people want to TP out early on, and then it just comes down to people realizing, okay, getting down wards that the enemy do not know about is extremely valuable. Do we value the TP out and smoke for it? Sure. So that's all it comes down to, really. And I think with any small change to the TP scroll's gold cost or even to the smoke, that would immediately change.
Bulba here, gonna be playing that offlane Sand King, and it's gonna have a bit of a challenge ahead of him here.
Not an easy lane.
Yeah, there's just too much lockdown here and now, so I don't imagine he's gonna feel too frisky about moving on forward and trying to find his own groove.
Yeah, this is one of those tri lanes where you just can't really get too close or you're instantly dead. Vengeful, Morphling, and Elder Titan. As soon as they hit level 2 as well, the lane becomes even more difficult. Right now he can feel a little bit safe, and he is going for the caustic finale.
Yeah. But they do have a pull camp to work with. Meanwhile, top lane, no secondary bounce there to hit on Tamu, but some good poking damage here. But it's still just the 2-on-1 for the Beastmaster here. And with the creep wave already getting closer to the tower, Mu is going to be okay with this. He's actually almost level 3 already.
Yeah, Mu is a fantastic offlane player. He knows exactly how to get the most out of it. I played safe lane against him a lot of times, and he's ultra aggressive, in fact.
I just really wish he thought of a better name, because now we have a Moo, a Moon, and a Moo, another Moo. So,
yeah, Moo. Moo and Moo.
Ain't easy.
Yeah, of course. Of course. Well,
Puppy is doing a pretty offensive jungle approach right now with his tomato friend here.
He is.
Going to go at Misery right now.
Dealing a lot of damage.
Misery's in trouble.
Misery is thinking about that bounty or that rune, but there's not going to be any way he can walk there. Oh, actually, they get Moo in the offlane here after a while.
Nice.
Managed to bring him down. Didn't see if he got a lucky bash or anything, but still get the kill. The Maledict skill up by Pyladai. Does add to their kill potential.
Whether it was a lucky bash or a lucky coconut bounce, I guess the extra bit of lockdown was more than enough to stack on the damage on top of the curse.
Or if he was just too cocky. He is one of those, as I said, ultra-aggressive offlane players, and it can be punished. But he will still be getting a lot of experience from this playstyle.
How is our mid lane matchup going right now? It looks like 11-2 here for Envy on his Morana to the 11-4 Weeha, so pretty split down the middle. I don't foresee, obviously, Weeha venturing out too far, kind of doing like a similar game like we see from our Death Prophets, planting himself in this mid lane and just grinding through it. Is it the same story for Envy here?
Oh, bottom lane.
They made a move for Bulba, Magic Missile, waveform forward. Puppy's here now, though, and Resolution may have committed just a bit too deep. He tries to bring in the strength, but it's not going to be enough. They get the finish there, and Puppy wants more. He's not going to catch out. Sokka on the sidelines here, but Misery.
Oh, they're on the hunt.
Back. Can Bulba? Oh, he doesn't
want to go. Just a level 1 stun, though.
Doesn't want to go for it, and Venge will TP all the way back to base.
It is dangerous to go into a Sand King. That caustic finale is very, very deceptive. Yeah. People underestimate so much how big impact it has. It slows down your movement speed, and it also hurts you so much every time it procs. And when you have that on a few creeps, and then Morphling waveforms in, yeah, it hurts.
No money for you.
To keep an eye down there. We knew this lane was going to be pretty frisky, but it's already living up to its name right now. Meanwhile, Moo witnesses that this camp is blocked out, so a secret ward has got to be nearby. Pretty unorthodox one right under the secret shop there, and Zed goes to wait for the 4-minute rune. Envy's heading that way.
Yeah, helping out with the control, so making sure Weeha gets the arcane rune that it is, or maybe, yeah, he's going to give some bottle charges over to Moo as well.
That leaves Puppy to sweep up a bounty rune for him, so Envy's going to be stuck with no bottle right now.
Yeah, he has the courier coming in, though, and the speed burst is available, so of course, when you pop that speed burst, courier's going to fly back home quickly.
Whee!
Yeah, get so far.
Off to fill it up, bring back some sweet juice there to Envy to kind of continue to pump out the extra bit of spam.
Nice creeps here for Puppy to gank with. He has the troll and the clapper. The tomato is really bringing a lot of damage. Oh, yeah. that's a strange attempt at ganking. They
I don't know.
That,
I wouldn't even classify that as a gank. It was They walked in like, we're in the lane.
I don't know. It doesn't work. But if they walked around with the Witch Doctor, there's in fact no high ground ward. And they could have maybe led with the coconut then. But of course, Weeha are going to be safe from that attempt.
Yep. And instead, they will take their business back towards the bottom lane here in hopes that maybe a new setup on Resolution could secure them another early prize.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a good play to go towards the lane that already made a mistake.
Yeah.
Since the Morphling is now struggling a little bit, if you can just bring some more hurt to his laning phase, that would be great. And Sand King is one of those heroes. As soon as he gets to run up and hit the creeps, he will take over the offlane quite quickly.
Looks like on the other side of things, Moo has gone to the jungle now to finish out his business there, leaving Arteezy with a free lane to farm up with on his Faceless Void. Is this a problem, or is DC going to be okay with just kind of letting this lane ride out as it is?
Right now, they don't really have the tools to contest Arteezy, but they should be taking the farm. Moo is going to TP in and get it, but bottom lane now, this aggression.
Comes an approach by Secret here, looking to make a move, possibly for Soxa, but looks like he's a bit out of reach.
Yeah,
and
staying
looks
safe.
Like said to just contest this pull camp and claim the XP for their own. A stomp will connect on the Pylite die here.
Yeah, but with the heal going, they think better of it. Not going to go in for that. And they also know that Mirana is swinging down here. So it could be very dangerous to take a fight. If she joins the fray, they would all die.
So also trying to keep tabs. Top lane, you always have Arteezy waiting with a Chrono here. And he's going to commit it from Moo. He had been knocking on for quite a while.
Got a bash as well.
TP's coming in. And
what?
He quickly can cancel. So Arteezy says, that's fine. I'll look to finish it up.
But he's so fast on Beastmaster.
He'll have the leap.
Why did he just immediately run away?
Oh.
Oh. He actually got a bash into Chrono as well. If he commits to Chrono and he gets a bash, he should be getting a kill. If not, then it was a mistake to Chrono there.
They were able to avoid it. It costed DC two different TPs to do so, but...
Sure. And bottom. The dive is not coming in.
Curse. Resolution. There's a stomp there to try to create some space for him, and it looks like he'll be fine.
Yeah,
pressure is on by Secret.
The creeps are just hunting him, though. Being bullied a lot right now.
Ouch, ouch. Oh my god. Three shots by Misery. Puppy loses over half of his life. Gotta be careful.
Yeah, TPM by Beastmaster as well. Gonna help out defending this bottom lane.
No level 6 yet, though, so doesn't have a Primal Roar to bring to this table yet.
Can Envy find any arrow here? Swinging down to bottom lane again. He has been spotted out, I think. Yeah, they saw him with the ward. Gets pinged out as well.
Sees a stack, though, and he'll take that one instead.
So, yeah. Good this mid, grab for him. Mid tower is taking a lot of beating as Envy leaves his lane again, second time. That's gonna allow Weeha to just do what every Dragon Knight player does.
Exactly.
Hit the tower.
Goes to work. I'm surprised he hasn't really committed the dragon form. Oh, he already has done a dragon form.
Yeah, he did it the previous time.
Yeah, he's definitely doing Dragon Knight things, that's for sure. Bottom lane, Bulba. Looks like a swing and a miss on the stun right there. Looking to connect on the resolution. Not gonna get the grab this time.
Oh boy, Misery.
Misery, Shockwave flies, Bulba, that one will connect. Misery's gonna get dropped right there. Another surprise approach, but Puppy this time proves successful.
Yeah, play around the Sand King in the early game. It's such a good game plan. He deals tons of damage, and these creeps are just great for fighting. And top lane, 10 seconds until RTZ has his Chrono again. Won't be able to kill Avenge under a tower, though. Ah, Envy gets the arrow as well on Weeha as he went for the rune, so he's gonna snag that right in front of his face. Bottom lane to dive! Everything! Yep, everywhere!
All over the place, Bulba way deep, manages to burrow back it away, but he'll still get dropped right there. Puppy sends the rest of the creeps back, but not before
one.
Misery gets the snag. Nice.
Good stuff there from DC as the counter gank that pretty heavily. And Moose just farming up jungle as well. I'm not sure which team I favor by the way things are going right now. Dragonite did do a lot of damage to the tier 1 tower, and it comes down to who's going to start pushing towers earlier, the DK or the Chen. I believe it's going to be the DK, but we'll see.
Now they're each team has cores that are finding a good amount of farm right now, and for others maybe a decent amount of fight participation.
Oh, Envy reveals the smoke.
Yep.
That's probably all he was doing there, in fact. I don't think he was even looking to arrow. Yeah. Now, though...
Okay, they move in. Burrow from Bulba leads to an Epi with a Maldic top, I think.
Oh, boy.
There's a lot of trouble here. It's just a wealth of damage, and they're going to have to let their DK go. Arrow, as a follow-up play, is not going to find a target. Secret, though, with a five-man movement to the mid lane.
Yeah, they're playing together, making good use of the epicenter, getting some damage done. And they ping out the ward as well, so I believe they're gonna buy up some sentry wards soon, maybe? Yeah, they have sentry wards coming down to bottom. Gonna try and get the ward on this cliff by Roche.
Looks good. They'll pull off by there. Mid lane, Arteezy made his appearance now. Still has that Chrono in his pocket if he'd like as he continues to work to finish out his Vlads.
Oh, this big stack here pinged out by Mu. He wants to contest this. Doesn't want it to be given away to Secret. Look at that. They're gonna make short you.
No, Envy? Envy's here now. Pops his invis. Could move in and get off a big hit. Starstorm will be unleashed. Connects with some creeps. Arrow, though, nowhere near.
A little bit off the mark.
Wii turns back. Gets hit with a coconut, so he can't get the dragon tail off. Oh, he didn't have it available anyways, but backs away.
Yeah, and they have RTZ right in the neighborhood as well with the Chronosphere, but they at least stop them from taking the big creeps. Gonna get that money over on Envy, and now they happen to be set up for a top push.
Yeah. No reason why they shouldn't just kind of move on in and claim the money on the map.
Definitely not.
Easy jumps on back here, but no close by target except for Mu here, who's not going to risk getting caught too far forward. DC will just have to take that one on the chin and just continue to find their farm elsewhere. Resolution continues his work here on the bottom lane, as he's just getting those early components. We already know that Morphling has just quite the item build up there, Waga, as he tries to at least get the first makings of his Lincolns together.
They just canceled the TP mid by Envy. If they now make a switch immediately bottom with the Dragonite ulti, they could take that tower if they realize, but it doesn't seem like they're going for it. DC, they're going for it now.
Envy is...
But Envy is starting to make his way, so he might be there in time to defend.
I don't see the urgency here from Weeha, so I'm not too sure if TC are privy to
that. I don't
think
they picked up on on that weakness. It's stuff like that that you need to abuse against some teams. You can get a tower that you otherwise wouldn't, and capitalize on when you know that you're going to be outnumbering the enemy. But they're still going to try and push a little bit with the Morphling, definitely not trying to take the tower.
There's a ping on Bulba, like they would want to make a move here. A quick drop of the Spirit and a Stomp is not going to be able to catch him. So they pull back.
Misery did this build in the previous game as well, where he puts 2 points into Astral Spirit early on. He doesn't like going for the aura immediately. It's an interesting build. Different from every other Elder Titan that I've seen. I guess he just likes the damage, wants to punch things.
Fair enough. I mean, he was hitting Puppy pretty hard earlier, so...
He was, yeah.
Can't really blame him for that.
Smoke breaks. Arteezy and Pyla die.
Are they going to commit the time walking chrono here, Arteezy?
Just avenge, though. You don't really want to. Maybe we'll jump in and try.
Blind chrono, just go.
Oh, right? God.
He's just casually walking
in. He kind of have to
Hi,
now.
Everybody. Then he time walks out. Okay. But gets hit, knocked from the stun. Swap back. He gets the chrono down defensively, but he still gets hit from the stun. Meanwhile, Pyla die steps in with a death ward to do work on the Soxa. Can't quite get the finish. Arteezy gets right back in, eats some breathe fire, and he's going to be forced to pull off. TC only lose one right here, but now Envy shows up, drops down the Starstorm, gets caught between the trees.
Sankey
now
stun?
Now continues to move on forward. Bulba looking for a target to get the stun. Weeha trying to run back and away. Good stomp for Misery, but Envy moves on in and gets connection here. One more shot should do it. Arrow, jump back, Wee gets the stun. Somehow still alive, but
Puppy
eventually they will get him. Weeha goes down at the same moment, and now comes out the roar from Moo for Bulba. But where's the follow-up? There it is, a magic missile, but there's no damage.
Yeah, this is very disastrous for DC. They're going one by one, now Soxa is left alone.
This is like a totally open playing field here with all the trees gone. Soxa, he is just gonna get,
look at that Witch Doctor just having the heal on. They can just keep sustaining this. They have the Vladimir's as well. Very hard to bring anyone down against this five men of secret early on. The Vladimir's plays a massive part in that because a lot of DC's damage is physical. So, very smart moves by Secret, and they just got outplayed there. They didn't really have that good focus, who they're gonna kill and how they're gonna do it.
And if I'm being honest, the most momentum we've been seeing from Secret pretty much today.
Yep, today, yep, for sure.
So, not looking to kind of hand this one over, and they're not stopping yet. Top lane, good connection with the Burrow.
Oh, he gets
center trailed a bit behind here because of that pesky boar, but eventually he will be able to catch up to Moo. Can Moo find a way out from this? It doesn't look like it. Throws out the Whirling Axes, and eventually Bulba strikes him down.
And they keep the momentum going as well. Secret, they might be on the way here to taking their first win of the day. That would be something for them.
Ooh, Envy just casually leaps up and over and happens to spot Misery. Misery will avoid the arrow.
Trying for the quick arrow. It does get a creep on the rear end of the arrow, at least.
But Envy holding all of that money before deciding to try to, I imagine, splurge into the Axe soon enough.
Yeah, I don't think there's any secret to what he's going for. I guess he has the infused raindrops and doesn't want to sell it before it's been used. So he's just holding that until he buys the point booster. I guess it's fine.
I mean, he's got a lot of mana regen, Aquila and the raindrops to work together.
That he does, yeah, for sure.
I've heard of most players like have often considered just replacing the Aquila because you have the raindrops and you sell it anyways.
There's even been players buying multiple raindrops. It's not uncommon, actually, seeing someone have two inventory slots full of them. They're just extremely high value. The mana regen's really great. And Arteezy is going for that Diffusal Rush build on Business Void after Vladimir's. So going to be a Manta Diffusal. Really good against the Morphling as well, as you can burn down his mana.
Not the game for the Radiance, huh?
No, definitely not. Radiance never against Morphling. Never. Because he will just clone you and then you're sad.
Fair enough.
There's a few ground rules about the Radiance.
If anyone wants to make rules, I'm sure you're the guy to do it.
Yeah.
So I'll believe
never against Slark, Morphling, or OD. Let's keep it at that. Simple rules.
Resolution, you know, he's got some farm. 2k, looking to build up for Lincolns. That's step one when you're a Morphling.
Yep.
Any multi-step program?
For a lot of players, it is. I like the Dragonlance first item bit more.
I actually don't see a lot of
that. You can even keep the Perseverance and Dragonlance, and then you just start building into other stuff. This game, I don't think Lincolns is super good, in fact. It's not going to block that much. It will block the Burrow Strike. Oh, bottom. We see Arteezy getting chain stunned.
Yep.
Oh, not quite.
Time walk away before the stun can come through for Misery.
Need more levels in that Dragon Tail. Yep. Would have worked, but he's only level 11 yet on the DK.
Resolution replicated back towards the mid lane and into an arrow by Envy, but he was able to kind of avoid any sort of additional damage with Envy holding all that gold and not finishing the Ags yet. I guess there's just not enough burst, so fall back and finish farming it up, which it looks like he's about to grab right now.
I think Secret should mobilize around this Void right now and start to make something happen with the Diffusal, because there's a push coming in and they are in position to contest that. Yes, Envy doesn't have any mana right now, and he's very close to getting his Aghanims. I understand that point of view. But they're gonna send him home with a Chen, I think, after he gets his money here. And then they could actually defend. Tower is under attack. Or even go fight. I see the puppy send home. Yep.
Go home and get that Ags.
Get your Ags, Marana.
I will, puppy. I will.
That's probably what Envy is saying.
Yeah, like, okay.
Alright, whatever, dude.
Arteezy, I'm right, I back you up, you know, I would figure putting this Chrono to use, putting this Diffusal to use might be in Secret's best interest.
They've got a massive power peak right now. Yeah. Blink Dagger on Sand King, they've got the Axe on Marana, Diffusal on Void, all the items are coming together, and over on the side of DC, they don't even have the Link has completed right now, so they are in a terrible spot if a fight was to erupt.
If a fight was to erupt.
Yeah, nothing saying that it might, you know, just this.
May, boom. There goes Bulba, leads in with the burrow, and Arrow's gonna connect. Swap back save from Zoxa, though, will put me on the high ground and alive for now. Meanwhile, never mind, they got him. Almost was able to save him, but.
Yeah, the Maledict and the Caustic Finale, very evil stuff.
Yeah.
A lot of damage over time.
Gonna be there. Meanwhile, top lane, Moo's trying to make it go for the tower, but Arteezy says, don't think about it, drops the Chrono, and begins to right click him down into solo submission.
Oh, no deny before killing him?
No.
I'm disappointed, Arteezy.
No ultra disrespect on that front. They will let him have the tower. Envy, though, disrespecting Captain Misery, will be able to shoot him down right from behind.
Good leap away as well from that magic missile. Gonna get away safely. Top rune taken by Bonturin for Morphling. But this tower mid is definitely gonna fall. And wins all over the map here for Secret. Been a long time since we got to say that.
Yeah, I mean, this is the Secret we've been expecting to see for most of these
games. Or hoping for.
Yeah, you know, they're. Now they're making it work. They've recognized their power peaks. They're looking to go in. Bulba, he recognizes now that Resolution has a Lincolns, and we'll take that note. But we looking to make him pay for that mistake. And can he do it? Yes, he can.
That's a life for the Lincolns fair. So I guess the Lincolns already paying off a little bit there for Resolution. As Bulba makes a little bit of an uncharacteristic mistake diving in like that.
Weehaw gets a little bit of redemption too after being taken down previous to that, and in dragon form with some time
Envy
to spare.
Envy has responded. Swap.
Make it go. There's a swap setup. Envy leaps out.
Okay, it's
still
home.
Connects, but yeah, puppy already ready to send home. Gets off an arrow first and a star storm. Ooh. That should be more than enough. Boo's gonna be going down. Weehaw moves in. They will get the response
well.
From Pi, and yeah, he's right back in the action. Envy ready to go here, and DC gotta get the hell back. But they got the Diffusal, Resolution, gonna get bashed on down. Earth Splitter comes up from Misery to try to help out, but Arteezy just time walks right past it to finish out what he started, and they'll be able to get it then and there.
And that should be tower and then a Roche probably for Secret. Great shape in this game two of the series. See if they head straight in towards the Roche. They have the physical damage to bring it down. Maybe? They have the Vladimirs?
Envy says, I can get another wave and...
Yeah, he's probably just taking that creep wave and then they're gonna go head over there. Nothing to lose as well as the tier 1 top has already been taken by DC, the typical trade for Roshan.
Mm-hmm.
So this is just gonna be DC in the top
Radiant's
spot.
Bottom tower is under attack.
And Ulti Orb in the pocket, Arteezy. Did you say it was going to be... Is that for the Manta, you
yeah.
think?
Yeah, yeah, Manta, right? Manta Diffusal Void.
This isn't a Chinese Void where we're going to see a Link.
No, the Lincoln's First is a very curious thing that the Chinese love to do, but I don't think it's stronger than the build that Miracle's been playing a lot, and a lot of Westerners have been playing. The Manta Diffusal is just very, very versatile. Works in so many scenarios.
Yep, and we also see the Force Staff pretty much complete here for Bulba and en route, so even more mobility, more ways
smoke.
To gap close. DC moving in, it's so close, they're smoking in, they have
to go!
Now!
Get in there!
Bird's flying to help with the vision, but Misery's gotta go now. Puppy gets hit,
They know the HP.
They're making their move. It's a roar there from Lou, but Time Walking sidestep. Arteezy's not going to be faded from it, and he'll pick it up. DC now, have they gone in too big? Have they bitten off more they can chew? They're trying to pull back it away, but Bulma moves in with the empty center, and it's going to hit hard and right onto Lou's head. He goes down. Resolution caught out. Nice stop, though, but an arrow and a death ward, all for Resolution. Morphling tries to muscle his way past it. Arteezy is going to be taken down. They get the Aegis Life here. Nice little coconut from Pileidai. Slows down Misery and Toxa in their tracks while we make chase. Now blinking forward. Connects with the Dragon Tail. Looks like Witch Doctor is going
to
go.
Yeah, Arteezy a little bit scared to take the fight there after you respawn with the Aegis. Just time walking away, not trying to capitalize on the people pursuing Pileidai. I think he could have fought a little bit more there. Max level time dilation is really strong.
Yeah, it did feel like DC could have been punished a bit more for the awkward situation
but
they were put in.
Great comeback, though, and bravery was rewarded Dyer's as they blink into Dragon Knight, get the stuns down, and yeah, just so close to getting an Aegis steal as well.
Mu's roar was pretty clutch, but not quite.
Mu was the only one really charging into the pit, though. They needed someone else getting in there. If they could get the spirit in there for a stomp, that would have been massive. But either way, Secret, their Aegis is burnt, so we're pretty much back where we started after that.
Yeah, it's not going to be a heavy-handed lead now for Secret, but just the moderate lead they've been building up at this point.
Yeah.
But what do you think, though? If the grind just kind of continues as it is, and let's say Secret are stunted from kind of progressing further in this objective game, maybe they fare in taking a tier 2 occasionally, but if this Morphling continues to grind up farm, put them together with all of the aura power they have, that going to be enough?
You should never underestimate a Morphling who gets his E-Blade with Elder Titan in the same team. The amount of burst is just insane, and we also haven't seen the natural order quite maxed out yet. So they can still get a lot stronger. DC, as they get scanned out here, going into the enemy jungle, Secret are going to stay safe. But there's potential, and we saw it in that last fight. They fought against Aegis and managed to win it. Surely they can win against Secret when they don't have Aegis then. The worrisome part, though, is this Manta style coming up on Void. It's going to make him really strong.
Yes, it will. I'm sure Puppy will look to try to take some steps here to get some wards. It looks like Pi, of course, will get those wards there and take back their jungle soon enough. Once DC is kind of cleared out from up here, but...
It is going to be a Lincoln Sphere.
Really?
Yeah, even with the Diffusal, he's going Lincoln's. It's really good against Beast and DK as they go in here.
Arteezy makes his jump, and he gets hit with the Dragon Tail and the Adaptive Strike. Roar's also there, but they still can't seem to burst him down. He's able to get the Time Walk off and reposition. He's good. DC may have just blown their load to get nothing from it. They've already lost Wii, Pileidai, and Company.
Yeah, that four staff, Bulba, just beautiful play. Now on the hunt to get as much as they can, Secret. Chasing after everyone. They're going to bring down Mu, and they're going to cancel the TP out as well. Soxa, not going to live.
Three down from DC. Secret lose nobody in a Bulba, good attempt up.
Bulba just saved Arteezy's life
For sure.
With that four staff.
He was locked down by everything.
He was getting the crack from the Elder Titan coming in. So yeah, most definitely would have died.
Weehaw with the quick trigger finger was able to connect with the Dragon Tail, the adaptive fall from Resolution, and then even Mu's roar on top of it, and still.
And
was
still
not quite enough.
Yeah, it's a hard hero to bring down the Carry Void, but now with Lincoln Sphere, he's going to be very, very hard to bring down, as you have too much single target, really, on the side of DC. It's a little bit of a weakness for them. If they get more Lincoln Spheres, they could actually go one more on Mirana. That's gonna really hinder their chain stun, which is super important. Of course, DK, Beastmaster, they struggle against this, and even Vengeful.
Definitely something to be concerned about. If Secret can itemize appropriately, it's not gonna be easy really to get a hold of everyone with the way DC, you know, just kind of burst out most of their DPS here, so we'll see them trying to crawl back, at least get some space on their side, but Secret have already made their move in and still have some proper aggressive vision here to just kind of play with the map a bit more.
Yeah, and we see DC are the kind of team that will not just sit back and do nothing.
Radiant's
though when starting to get pushed
attack.
Back. They still look to get out on the map, trying to push out all lanes and set up to do something, but the timing for them is really when Morphin gets the E-Blade. You need that shotgun. Not gonna be able to kill stuff, and he's very close.
Right now he's just a pea shooter.
Yeah, but...
gotta get the big boys, the big guns.
Yeah, the big guns are close. 2.7k.
Okay, we got a Moonlight Shadow though from Secret here. What's the plan? Envy, striding down mid lane. Blink cross. Just Bulba, force, blink, jump, Sasuke, dead. Bye.
Cool, guys, don't look at explosions.
That was like a hitman job right there. They went in, they got what they needed, and they didn't look back.
Remember, kill the sports.
I don't even know what their name is. I don't want to know what your name is. I just want to get the job and go.
It's just for the money.
So good snipe right there by Secret. And that is going to get DC a little bit nervous heading out.
That's the kind of position they're in. They're in a position to bully as soon as DC go out to push these lanes, try and get on the map. Secret should be shutting them down and saying, hey, where are the guys playing here? Because they're in that commanding lead right now. Radiance middle tower. And tier 2 tower taken down on mid as we see RTZ building into that Manta subsequently after the Lincoln Sphere. He's getting some heavy stats, stat gain from that as well.
Yeah, he's going to be a tough cookie to crack, that's for sure. He pulls off with the rest of his team, and Secret continue to kind of go down the docket of what they want to do, taking a little bit to the map.
Stealing the stacks as well on the Ancient, not bad.
Yep.
And of course, there's still a long time until Roshan could be up, so should just be looking to take the bottom tier 2 probably as the next objective, or even top.
And he goes on the
boy, Saxa not again!
He's running back towards his Morphling comrade, but Morphling also getting chased down here. This is just going to be Avenged Takedown. Resolution says, sorry, I gotta go. What he doesn't know is Envy was actually on chase behind him with the Invis, so just another snipe takedown. And Venge, who's just trying to get out there to provide some vision for his team, provide some intel as a scout.
Yeah, she's trying to do anything she can. It's a tough warding job. She knows that she got picked off under an observer ward, so she was running out to try and deward that, but doing so, she died again to the very same ward. It's never easy.
And in my pubs, that's when my team goes, stop feeding, noob! I'm like, guys!
And at the same time, we need more vision. Yeah. It's a hard life. But right now, Secret are just in a dream position, and I think they should be enjoying this after today, which has been, for anyone who missed it, a rough day. And look at Chen. Very close to the entire Aghanims now.
Yep. What's over in the old ancient camp? Nah, it's unfortunately just a big thunder hide.
Just crap.
Crap! We need a golem. We need a dragon.
Oh boy.
The goods. Bulba moves in, sees fellow offlaner Mu.
And, not so much a fellow anymore.
They're going to make chase. He's a fugitive now. And a hunted man.
He really is. He slowly will be pursued and then quickly he will die. But they do get a pickup on Envy. Oh. Massive kill. E-Blade going to work. The blink from Weeha appears to have been what led to the initiation, of course. That was some good kill to get.
Good simultaneous action here. And take one of their own.
To mention, he is also building in towards the Lincoln Sphere on Mirana. So RTZ and Envy, both of them.
Pretty fitting.
It's going to be even better when the E-Blade now is up Radiant's on Morphling. There's just more incentive to buy it. Honestly, they could finish this game having Lincoln Sphere on the tanking as well.
Yeah, that Lotus Orb something. I mean, Lotus Orb would be good having the extra armor. Resolution, though, after committing it with a waveform, gets hit with a Chrono and a Death Ward. He's in trouble. Epi on top of it. Everything in the kitchen sink for Resolution on that one.
Oh, blink up by Weeha. TP up. They pinged him, but then they don't get out.
Whoa.
Oh, they don't believe in it.
They don't believe.
They pinged it themselves. They're like, yeah, he probably blinked up. And then they're like, nah, he's already gone. And might have been true that they couldn't have time to run up there. But, man. Nice little reaction by Weeha. Gets out safely, at least.
Losing resolution doesn't make it any easier just before it. But here comes Secret again, mid lane. Right as Misery's trying to deward. Bulba, the gap closer, sets up another one potentially. And it looks like it's going to happen. Nuke down by Puppy, and then a nice little caustic cherry on top.
Claim
the last hit.
Top lane as well.
Doesn't get any easier here. Troubles a brewing as Mirana under the moonlight shadow rounds the bend. Sees Mu. That's going to be the casual Ag Starstorm.
Ooh, he
pops out the
bench.
Book. Leaps. Makes it back in a way. Hit with the magic tower. Missile here. This is awkward. DC very out of position and possibly outnumbered, but they make the move for Envy after Lincoln's is going to be popped. They hit him with the roar. They hit him with the missile. Is it enough? Envy trying to get out of the way.
So close.
He's almost there. Leap. No, not going to make it. He gets brought down. Weeha looks to go for Puppy while Bulba is able to snipe and take down Mu. Wee on the back outside makes away from Bulba, but here comes Resolution. Pop shot takes down Pylite Eye.
Gem as well.
Boom. They get that. The gem now on the deck is Secret lose 4. trying to make the best of a situation, fighting without their Void.
Yeah, fighting without their Void, but also fighting without their Epicenter. They used everything to burst down the Morphling on bottom, and now Morphling just says, hey, you don't have shit. I'm coming in, and I'm gonna kill you.
Yep.
And that was some good confidence by DC taking that fight. Beautiful stuff, and getting that gem as well. This is the kind of stuff that can turn a game. And the entire pipe seems to be complete on Saxa.
There's a lot of money now suddenly rolling in for DC.
Look at Saxa's kills!
Gets two.
He got 880 gold for killing Envy, and then he got 670 for killing a Chen. Saxa just getting rewarded.
And the other breadwinner was Resolution, claiming two kills. His Morphly, after dying, he suddenly got about 3,700 gold to his name.
Yeah, and the experience also kicking back. We got a game on our hands against Coddle. This was really in Secret's corner.
Yeah, this was supposed to be Secret securing themselves at least that one win and looking like they were heading to the promised land soon enough, but DC with the fight back now and with that Morphling game.
Showing tenacity, and I love what I'm seeing from DC now. They have a lot of combinations. The Epicenter is going to be great for mitigating the sanking. The one thing that DC have been struggling with, though, is this Blink 4-staff sanking. He has been catching everyone across the map.
Really has, and plus Puppy hasn't really been able to unveil like any sort of ancient creeps to kind of pair along with his mighty team, and you still have to fear for Secret when they are all together.
Yeah, they're hoping to get some good spawn on the next one.
Time flies.
We'll see. Everyone is kind of heading towards this bottom area right now. There is a DD rune on the Mirana, by the way, who might be looking to come and join the fight.
Yeah, Roche is also up, so a good fight here could lead to a plus one on that Roche. An Aegis, and then another mighty swing of momentum. Resolution to the top.
Oh, the smoke.
Manta style is en route for him.
DCR up to something here, has to have the replicate as well. Morphling could join. And they're thinking about going up this dangerous ramp here.
Yeah, the bird is there to help kind of give a little bit of vision, but they don't want to walk down any sort of casual path where a ward may spot them out.
Yeah, you also can't really overcommit on one guy, because Void and Sanking, these are heavily punishing heroes, even Witch Doctor with the cask and the ulti. You have to respect them. Don't go into a five man of Secret.
Buffy does eventually get with that ancient granite golem. He also has picked up a little Ogre Frost Mage to help with the armor on his team. Good against the Elder Titan.
Really good against it. And that, of course, granite golem gonna help out people who might get bursted down by the Morphling Adaptive Strike.
Yep. And Secret are going to be migrating all the way up to the northern front here. DC with their smoke movement are not going to be walking Dyer's away with any gank. It was just too awkward of a position. When Dyer are like in that area, it's like you always have to feel like you're moving into high ground area to try to take a fight.
Sure. They got a lot of tower damage done though with this Morphling Manta style. So that top tower is already in deny range to tier 2. And they also forced Secret Dyer's to kind of follow along their lines right now. DC definitely getting more control, but definitely more map presence in this game.
They definitely at least got it back. It felt like they were already getting that noose thrown around their neck by Secret here, but they have definitely taken their jungle fully back, it feels like. I say that, but Secret are beginning their prowl.
And with the 10-second BKB as well, they could take a powerful fight, but here is Secret with the smoke rotation again. Can they find anything?
Well, this is happening. Envy is up in that top lane here.
And like he's been spotted up there as well.
Yeah.
So that's a big thing. They know that they're not going to play down Dyer's here if they have Envy all the way over there. Most likely. But they're going for the big wraparound.
They're walking past a replicate.
Oh, no.
Oh, he manted. They burrowed and everything. Thank goodness that wasn't a chrono also committed, but
yeah, no full panic. Yeah, they definitely know exactly what's happening now. The Titan is also going to scout it out. And Roshan looking like a nice thing on the menu here for Secret.
They go in, they go to work.
Yeah,
DC do anything about it. Doesn't look like they're going to be in any sort of position.
They're going to get it for sure. Morphling doesn't have a replicate ready.
Yep.
So no way to get there and contest it. And now with these creeps, Ken is just really set. He should get rid of the Swiftness Aura probably from Hellbear if he can find the Wolf or maybe even a Troll for the Ensnare. But he's got some great creeps right now.
Oh, for sure. Mighty army here. Like Puppy Chen.
Puppy Chen plays it pretty well.
Puppy Captain Chen.
DC. Puppy Thump Bomb.
All the way up and above for DC here. Now really having to go against an Aegis here. Is it... in their interest to stall things out?
For sure. You just want to keep it a little bit slow. You don't necessarily want to teamfight into a Void and Sand King in the first place, and now with the Aegis on their hands as well. You just tell Secret, hey, you want a teamfight? Okay, come to our base. We'll take a teamfight then. Until then, we'll just be farming. We've got the Morphling. Hey, I see a point booster on Saxa. He's building into the Aghanim's Bench. Oh, they're going on RTZ.
A lot of fun. Gonna get the RTZ grab. Lincoln's is gonna be popped. That means the Warp can connect, and with the shotgun fire, he'll lose his Aegis life. Looks like DC will evacuate the premises once they get that kill.
Oh, do they get out cleanly? They do.
They will. Oh no! Oh. And it was spotted and pinged out too.
Yeah. Some people may have seen that, but that's just unfortunate. That was a brave attempt to take down the Aegis. They felt really confident having the Hawk to scout for them. They felt that, okay, they're not close enough. We can kill the Aegis and just get out. It's a very quick hit and run, and it worked out. Pretty high risk, though, going for that kind of play.
Yeah, that's happened two times now, right? Where Aegis has been acquired by Secret, but they haven't been able to put to the use they'd like. They either have to sacrifice it right away, or DC have found a way to just snag it right up.
That's true. DC have denied that in a very effective way. Last time by just taking the fight at the Roche pit, and this time Radiant's by quickly sniping it off the carry.
They're not allowing Secret to just kind of begin to run away with an advantage and having something like that. They just want to continue to show them that they have the fight in.
Yeah, and there's been a massive recovery going as well for the side of DC in terms of Morphling. Look at him. He just overtook the Void in top farm. And now buying up an entire BKB as well. He is looking mighty strong, this Morphling.
So, Secret, I mean, they did just lose their Aegis, but should they be moving forward? They need to kind of, you know, I don't know, it's a Morphling
game. I feel it messes with your head. You just had Aegis, and the enemy just go and kill your carry. They don't care about anything. You get scared right now, and they play scared. And look here, we are coming.
Not
coming
scared
in.
Is DC. They smoke, they move right in. They could end up creeping in from behind. They're going to spot out Arteezy. Still no chrono for about 10 seconds. They make their jump, they make their kill. It's on Puppy. Meanwhile, Arteezy makes a move for Misery. There's a swap save from Soxa, keeps him alive and well. Time dilation is going to be there under resolution. Epi flying from Bulba. It's all on Soxa here. There's the chrono off cooldown now. They're able to get Weeha, but he's the only one right clicking him, so he changes targets and goes for Soxa instead. But then Weeha's out. He gets off the Dragon Tail, and they're going to get the focus and the kill. It's a triple for resolution. DC taking the game right back and saying, no, Secret, there will be no easy win for you today.
Just barely getting away as Weeha almost snags a courier as well. Dyer's on top of all that. The gem was actually lost from DC though, and over on the side of Secret, but they got so many kills Dyer's for it.
Now inside the base, Dyer's a buyback is going to be forced by Arteezy, and DC might just take that, be happy with it, and get the hell out.
Yeah.
Except they will.
I think that's all they need to do. I believe Mirana might have been able to defend that even without the buyback. At least blinking in, clearing all the creeps could have deterred the enemy, but the buyback now forced as well. DC are going to be smiling all the way back to base.
That was what looked like very all over the place there, a bit by Secret. You had one Bulba jumping in, he committed in for Soxa a bit. Arteezy gets a chrono, set up for Weeha.
There were some great plays in terms of just the support on DC. You had Misery getting caught out at first by Arteezy, but quickly they swap him with Vengeful, which led to Arteezy time walking to chase. And in a team fight, if you're Void, you never want to time walk before taking damage. So he time walked closer to get the kill, but then he was right next to a Morphling who says, oh, you just used your survivability, I'll just click you. And he had to run away and subsequently died. It was just amazing play by DC. I was quite impressed by it.
See if DC can hold onto this advantage they've been given their way. As Secret, though, look to go on their own offensive. Radiant did use a nice scan, and it's going to be spotted. Puppy walks right through it here. What are DC going to do with that information?
They used a good scan, but they also got spotted by wards.
Uh-oh, Envy's right on top of him there with the Shivas. Didn't notice him pick that up.
Yeah.
Pops it and leaps away.
Interesting build. Trying to clear the mass of creeps with the Necrobook and trying to deal with this army a little bit more, and of course does slow down the attack speed plenty. I'm not quite sure about that build, but
yeah, I mean,
we'll see.
I fear that they just will be lacking a bit in the damage department because he's not going to be there side by side with Arteezy just dealing out the deeps.
Yeah, the E-Blade and the Veil and even some of the physical damage builds, I can get behind all of those. The Shivas doesn't really bring much damage at all. It does bring some control. It is good together with the Sand King, but
yeah, and you get armor against ET, which is nice, but
I feel that Sankin could maybe have built that in the future anyway for their team, and he just goes for Veil into E-Blade, for example, that we have seen other Mirana's do, but I'm not sure. We'll see if it works for him.
We'll definitely keep a sharp eye out on that front, while DC opt to pull back after pressuring down that bottom lane.
Oh boy, this yep. Morphling.
He now has the Scotty now to match that sweet cosmetic he's got on his back right there. The Eye of Scotty.
He's looking sick right now.
Tried and true for your Morphling.
He's got all the farm you could want at 41 minutes. He doesn't have travels. That's the only thing I guess you could say is really missing. Moonshard up, of course, as well. But he is such a big center of the team fight right now. And it's not even about the shotgun, really. It's about all the physical damage he has. 319 base damage, then you add Venge on top of that. That's 100 more damage just by Venge.
Question. I know it's not happening this game, as there is going to be a quick resolution shot blast on Puppy.
Sure.
Actuar mad scientist hybrid morphling thing. If you happen to hybrid a Dragonite while he's in dragon form, you get that, right?
He would be range form, yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
He would be range form, and he would have the range stomp on the dragon tail.
Ooh, very cool.
Yeah, I've been doing a lot of tests. My hybrid science.
Hybrid is just one of those things I feel like is just an untapped skill ceiling.
It's an interesting thing. Definitely not something you tap into often as a carry morphling, though. I mean, we're not going to see it here, sadly. Yeah. It's a very interesting mechanical question, though, what hybrid works with and what it does.
Yeah, we saw earlier the fun thing, if you happen to hybrid a Wraith King with the Nags, indeed, you will rise up.
It carries the effect around it, yeah. The illusion will carry the Wraith effect when someone dies, which I didn't expect, but you learn more every day, you test stuff, I guess. Right now, DC just controlling the Roche area. Could not be up yet, so a little bit early on the scouting. DC, are you not taking your Roche timings?
Mm-mm. They'll scout it, they'll wait, they'll hang.
But great split push by Secret, though, on this top lane.
Like Shadow committed.
Yeah, they were looking for anything that they could find someone to farm this top lane, but DC is just hanging tight together. He's going into a butterfly after Shiva's butterfly. Wow, this is a strange kind of build, but definitely Morphling does not have MKB and does not want to buy an MKB.
Very true.
I'll give him that. And same for the DK. So, could be a good item for sure. I'm more on board with that than the Shivas. Sadly, I feel the two items kind of have a... like a counterintuitive synergy. You go armor first and then you go evasion. If you're getting armor anyway, then you want to get hit in a way, right? Like,
yeah.
It's not bad together, it's just that you're kind of focusing too much against the right click, and your deeps is really not going to be great.
Pick one motive and go with it.
Yeah. Are you my art teacher now or something?
Here comes DC now, still. Making sure they can fend off Secret from claiming this Roche. It would be
And DC are really just hugging up, and in fact, the Rune of Destiny was spawned as well. So when Roche respawns, which will be very shortly, that's going to be quick and good Roche.
Is it necessary for Secret to try to make a move there if feasible?
I would say so, but at the same time they have great high ground defense. And at this point they have a smoke, they want to smoke out, so they're wanting to do it. It's just that all these lanes need to be pushed. Morphling is really getting into their heads and they're gonna smoke up in the end here, I think. We'll see if they can find anything. They have a centaur as well, messing with the DC, so good intel. They haven't smoked up though. Maybe they just think better of it.
And no hard commitment from either team yet, whether it's going into the pit or moving out from base. Roche is up now. He's ready for a fight. Are DC going to give him that fight here and now, or are they going to give him a little bit of mercy?
Gonna push out mid, but her Mirana Invis was pinged out immediately. DC really on top of their map awareness, so they know there could be sneaky movements coming in, but they have tons of sentries and wards.
Yeah, they have a ward.
They see everything.
Side. They have like the Tinker ward up.
Dear God.
Yeah, I don't think.
And they scan the area they don't see as well. And in fact, it was not them. Okay, it was Dire scan. Whatever.
Yeah, they see the replicant.
No.
And they're committing some stuff for it there. While that happens, they're going to be finishing off the Roche. The cheese still inside. It looks like Moo's going to move in to grab that one up. But as a Morphling Aegis here.
No boots Morphling. He's a tank. Look at him. 313 movement speed of pain.
slithering little water man. Moving up towards Secret, and do Secret have their towels ready?
It's heavy water, man. It's dangerous stuff.
And it's not the posture position you want to be in here. Secret just waiting for the inevitable push while their cores are out splitting the map and finding farm in the meantime.
And DC are really happy about this. They're just getting so much money, getting items on every single player. It's not just about the Morphling, even though we're hyping him up a lot. The DK is getting quite fat.
Yeah.
And even the Beastmaster, of course, farming up on top lane. Oh, getting caught up though. On the top lane.
Oh, spoke too soon. Moves done.
Farming a bit too much as Arteezy is hanging in the neighborhood.
But they make a jump on their own here. DC committing in, looking to go for Bulba. Bulba does get the Force and the Sandstorm off. And then even sent back home by Puppy just in case.
Yeah, gonna be safe.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Secret just holding on, and with that guy going down without your Beastmaster, you definitely do not push. And Arteezy is right now just saying, hey, you need to come back and defend here because I'm getting a lot of money on the Happy Void.
What does he do with that money? He's got nearly over 5k now.
There is some merit to going Refresher, actually. I think that's one of the items that can be really strong, but with Mirana lacking so much in the physical damage department, I would probably just say that Daedalus is a great item. His illusions are gonna hit so hard with it. Would be really, really strong for him. I don't think he needs to go MKB because Morphling still hasn't picked up a butterfly. Yeah, I believe Daedalus is a good choice. Or a Refresher, any of those.
We'll see what the option's gonna be. DC had continued to hang around in that bottom lane.
He could man down and go BKB as well. But
man down.
Then he man down. Yeah.
Played it safe is what we like to say.
No. That's tame.
You can see the hesitation from both these teams. This is such an important game for both of them. I mean, with a win here, DC have pretty much secured their spot into the upper bracket where the real money begins.
Exactly.
And if Secret get a win, you know, they're still in somewhat contention in hopes for a strong day three showing.
Exactly. Being in the upper bracket, you would guarantee that you're not in that bottom four.
Scary best of one.
Exactly. Scary best of one, and you also immediately get into some money, so very important game for DC, and they're playing it very methodical. They did die before, but now we're back in the same scenario. They have the option to go high ground push. Aegis is online on the Morphling. You definitely want to use it.
Here they come. We'll see what they can do with it here. He's off first. Gets
into
dragon
Morphling
form.
Is splitting. He's going to rat it out. He's been spotted, though.
Weapon above. Moves in with the Manta there right inside. Ooh. And that's the fast replicate to put him right back in below. As DC continue their assault. Tier 3 getting a bit of damage. Puppy going to get stunned up, but then there's the quick glimmer. Tier 3 ends up going down. DC might pull off, but Weeha's the man left behind. Sokka says, I got you, and looks to bail him out. Chrono only for the Venge, though. Earthsplitter will fly on forward. They can't even kill the Venge yet. They'll finally be able to bring her down, but that only unleashes her untapped potential from the grave. Resolution moving in, looking to seal things up. Sees Envy, goes for Pi.
Oh, the Illusion
backs on out.
Still alive. He can still swap people. He can still stun people. But
he's there. He's still fighting.
Spirit. He is still there.
Snipe up by Lydai. Resolution will shoot him down. Looks to go for Envy Neff, but Envy gets him with the Star Storm and with an arrow. He'll lose his Aegis. Second life to come out here. Still no Pi in the battlefield.
I love to watch this Illusion. It's like, I'm still here, boys. I'm still here.
That's so much value.
Yeah, it
is. A free stun, a free swap.
No, truly. Like, he has such a long range swap as well. He tried to swap there, but of course the Lincoln's going to protect
him. He was so tanky in that fight. He was solo chrono for him, but with the pipe, with the ags.
He also had his friends behind him, just helping out with the stomp from Elder Titans. That disrupts people. Looking for a swap on the Chen, maybe? Gotta get it?
They're thinking about it. Resolution wants to go in and try to hit him fast. Lincoln's is gonna be popped. Seems to be the end of it there.
And Venge is respawning, so the Illusion dies. Living 100% of the time.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, until someone just takes this your Illusion or mana drains it. But
yeah.
This game, pretty good game to have it, in fact.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, Secret do hold. They lose a tier 3. Raxus will still stand for them.
They also have a ton of money on Seacrest. They have 5k on the Mirana right now. I'm not quite sure what he will be building into, but obviously we haven't been quite sure what he's been building into up to this point either. Yeah. With a Shiva's Butterfly, it's an interesting transition.
Yeah, kind of for both of them. Arteezy too, when he decided to segue, got the Lincolns, which seemed to work out nicely, but now he even goes for the AC.
I love that AC though. That is a great pickup. And it's going to make them a lot stronger. Against Elder Titan, adding this bonus armor to your team, as long as you don't get shotgunned by the Morphling, you might be tanky enough to hold for a little bit.
Imagine how much armor Emmy's going to have once he's hanging near Arteezy. I mean, you already get the Butterfly Agility armor added. He's got the Shivas
on
hand.
He's got some crazy armor.
Yeah, he's not going to be taken down lightly.
Yeah, 48 armor, in fact. And that's without a large dragon, of course.
That's crazy. All right. DC forge their way back up.
Still their game to win.
Yeah. Ball is still in their court. The action has slowed down a bit.
Yeah. I feel that they're trying to get one more item on Mu. They just want to get something more. But ever since he got that travels, the refresher is very far off. Would have been a great item for him for sure. And other than that, I think only a hex would really be of interest. Maybe actually the Assault Cuirass, in fact. Okay, yeah, that. But I think they're gonna build that on Weeha anyway. He's got quite a bit of gold, in fact.
Ooh, yeah. Secret. Moving in. But then quickly moving out. Yeah. They have that ward on the high ground. But DC also have their own bit of vision.
Yeah, they have the gem, so quickly taking out that ward. And right now, Secret are just saying, okay, if we take any fight, it will be in our base. They have lost 2 tier 3 towers. They're very exposed in their base. And this is when Resolution could get crafty.
He's got over 7k gold.
As a Morphling, he could be using a replicate and then just running on her to the other side, forcing people to go on him. I think that's what we might be seeing soon here. Just a good old split push. And he's going down bottom, TPing.
Yep, here he goes. He's got some morphs mid. He leaves the rest of his team up top. And he's going to begin to try to split apart Secret as fast as possible. Envy, though, already pings it out, and looks like he's thinking about heading that way first and foremost.
They're going to burst on the Morphling with everything they have. They'll try and bring him down.
Let's see if they can get it. They connect with the Chrono, but he begins to morph into strength.
He should live.
Yeah, he should. They're trying their damage, though. Bulba steps in, though, helps him out, and they will be able to take the Morphling down. The rest of DC frantically move into the base up and above to try to see how much work they can do. Only able to get that tier 3, and nothing else to follow.
Yeah.
Secret, get back on
tier 3 already down, actually, so they haven't gotten anything yet. Of course, not the Glyph, turning on Envy.
Oh, Envy eating a huge wealth of damage right there. Weeha, though, going to get locked out, turns back, and should be able to get the final pot shot. The Earth Splitter is going to be the one to finish him off. And
Arteezy is here. He's really, really strong. Saxa going to die very quickly to him.
And the Fusel jumps in.
Bulba is looking for more.
Wait a bit. Will they get the Illusion too? Stomp's there.
Well, they're taking this fight. Weeha is going in.
Thinking about it, jump in, but Arteezy knocks him in the head. There's going to be the swap from that Illusion. Bulba stumps back in one more, and he's still hit up with a lot of fire, though. Weeha continues his chase. We'll be able to finish him off.
Arteezy getting more and more lonely here by the minute, but Weeha is a very low HP dragon.
Yes, he will, and it looks like he will suffer the right-click damage. Another knockdown going to be there.
Puppy's like, yeah, that's my...
Puppy and his army, the one entourage that is all that, I guess, Arteezy needs by his side.
Jesus Christ, the items that Puppy has in this game, he's actually so farmed on the Chen.
They pull off, though, and DC realized this is not going to be easy to close out. And they try to do that crafty plan with the Morphling sending Resolution to the bottom, but...
Yeah, but there's Secret, so much burst. They have a lot of chase on them.
Hit him with everything they had, man. It took a lot of firepower.
I thought he would live, and then the Bash comes out from the Void in the Chronosphere, so he stays bashed after. And that allowed Bulba to get close enough to get the Sanking stun. Man, it was really just barely that the Morphling died there. Barely is enough.
What is the next step now? Resolution still sitting on a
Roche
serious
is alive.
Roche is up. It seems like that may be it. There's already our first ping. Secreter in the neighborhood here. And for DC, they gotta just get back to their bearings.
I honestly think that Resolution would be much happier having a Satanic than the Manta style at this point. Or even the Lincolns. Getting rid of the Lincolns. It gives you much more HP, so you can stay alive. And it also allows you to go back from that low HP. Just contemplating his gear cap here. Oh boy, Roshan does die really quick here to Secret.
Very, very quick. DC are close, but they're not going to be close enough. Sasuke's going to try. The wave is there, but it does go down. There's the Earth Splitter also going to be committed. Does connect on both Pi and Arteezy. Sasuke in the mix. Weeha jumps in. He's going to be able to get the grab. It takes up Puppy right away. Arteezy in a bit of trouble. Does manage to chrono and time walks all the damage back and off, but doesn't have the firepower himself to be able to follow it up. Now he's stuck inside the pit. He couldn't leap away. That cost him his first life. The DC surround him, ready with the stomp, but he still manages to get out of trouble. Resolution makes chase. Swaps right back into the pit. What was that? Doesn't matter though. Weeha will be able to be there. Gets him with the stun, and he'll finish off what they started.
Yeah, that was almost a fatal mistake, but Arteezy will go on in the end. Of course he has buyback, because we're in the very late game here, but DC are coming down the mid lane. On buyback forced already on Chen, and more to follow.
Envy pushes out the top lane as fast as possible, but quickly gets right back into action here on the defense, where he is going to be needed. Here comes the rotation in from Resolution now.
They don't have the Chronosphere. How are they going to take the fight, though?
We have to see. Chen army out in full force. The Star Storm crumbles down. They're trying to get rid of as many creeps. Envy deep into enemy space here.
Preview.
With the stun, the swap back right now. Bursted, shot it down. Resolution's going to get that mark, and the buyback is going to fly out from Envy as Arteezy's already in the mix. Looking to move on
chase.
In. Sasuke in trouble, chops down on that cheese, heals right back up and tries to tank all the pressure from Arteezy from the rest of his team.
Split push for Morphling, he's going for the racks on the top, going for buildings.
Gets hit up from an arrow though, from Envy, as Envy leaps in with the Shivas, looks to right click him down, and Resolution tries to just muscle it off and finish what he started. Can he get it done? Yes, he can. Tries to knock Envy, the Lincolns is going to pop up the adaptive, he gets hit from the stun.
He is left for dead.
Good. Finally, they'll be able to bring him down with the power of the Epicenter helping out.
Yeah,
they back out and away.
That was two big forced buybacks though. The buyback on Arteezy and on Envy, of course on Chen as well, but that one we don't really speak about. DC now, when they respawn, they're going to be in a great position. Of course, Secret need to beeline down the mid lane, force out this Morphling buyback, else they're in big trouble.
Then Secret trying to clench on hope of being able to claim at least one win today in day two of group stage. DC need this win to claim a spot in the upper bracket. They're both hungry. They want it.
Who wants it more? That's the big question. But Secret, they're now in a pretty perilous spot, but they've been so in all this game. And here we are, 58 minutes. They're still holding on. They do not want to lose this one. I think right now, going to be happy just sitting in their base and chilling it out. DC, 50 seconds though. Long time for that Morphling.
And obviously don't want to have to have him splurge on the early buyback at this point.
I'm surprised that
absolutely necessary.
Arteezy's been farming jungle so much. Instead of just going down mid and forcing out this Morphling buyback, they're a little bit scared. And it comes down to the fact that if they try and force buyback, there is the risk of getting caught out. And if Arteezy or Envy dies, they've kind of lost.
Yeah, it's over.
So they're gonna not be able to force Resolution on this one. And a buyback on a 10,000 casual gold, level 2 travels Morphling with gear cap, he can definitely put some hurt on your buildings.
Yeah. Looks like Resolution will get to hold onto his buyback here, but Secret are not looking to leave quite yet. We'll have to see if DZ look to go back on the offensive once Resolution's back by their side. We are already out in front. Are Secret going to get tempted to make a jump play here?
Ooh, definitely.
Looks like they are.
They are baiting.
Weeha! He actually makes the ambition jump. He's going to go for Pi. He pops his own BKB. And Secret forced to double back and reposition. Here comes the rest of the DC army. Jumping in. There's Arteezy committing with the Crota, but a nice swap back from Sokka. Bulba looking to move in with the Epicenter, trying to hit up Weeha, but Weeha still holds on. And now comes the Mighty Morphling. Shrekking on through, getting in with the right clicks, and is able to bully down Bulba. And now looking for more. Pylight is going to be going down next. Starstorm crumbling down from Envy as he stopped and put to sleep, but it's not going to be enough. Here comes Moo! Hits Arteezy with the roar, and that is going to do it then and there. Resolution cleans up with a double kill, and back on the other side, they are looking for the scrappy Envy, leaping back in the mid lane, but he goes right into the Dragon Tail.
And Bulba has to save his friend here, four-staffing him, trying to keep Envy alive. And seems like he will get away, but now DC just gonna head down the mid lane as well.
No Arteezy for 100 seconds, no buyback for him, no buyback for Puppy, out for a minute.
They also don't even have the Sanking Epicenter, so right now his best bet is to just split push along with this Mirana. And they've been spotted, in fact, but it doesn't really matter. They still need to do Radiant's something. Bottom tower is stop under this from happening.
The golems are like, stay back, creeps. You're not moving down this lane.
The buddies, the brother golems.
Doesn't Dyer's matter. Doesn't stop these two. They're already inside the base. They're going for the racks. The glyph is going to be forced out.
Factor region is really cute at this point. You don't really care much if you're morphling. Look at that damage.
Oh, my. Oh my.
Makes you think of
are
how hard it can be.
Are we about to see Secret get shut out the whole day in three different series going 0-6 while DC claim, well, the top spot in their group? What world are we living in, Waga?
Yeah, this is just amazing for DC, but Secret, everything is just going wrong and they might even get thrown against the backdoor region right now. Buildings are falling.
Might get a snipe on Mu.
Very good pickup.
On the back end side, but that doesn't stop DC from moving.
He gets two pickups, in fact.
Surprise! Is this going to be enough? A buyback comes out from Misery. Bulba.
Gone.
Out for 100 seconds, no buyback there. Nice death ward, though. Comes out from Pylite Eye. Forces Resolution to back up and away. He wants the man up here for Envy. Moves back from the dead. He ends up roaring himself, but it doesn't matter. The initial roar is going to be there, and it helps isolate and finish off Envy. Resolution goes back to what counts. And DC move in, and they're going to do it. They 2-0 Secret and might have just secured their spot into the upper bracket. Secret. What a dark day for them, though. 0-6.
0-6, and they're now on a 7-game losing spree here at the group stage.